Hi everybody, in today's lecture we are going to study about trigonometric function. The word trigonometry is derived from the Greek words trigon plus metron, trigon and metron, in which trigon means triangle and metron means measure. Okay, so trigonometry means measuring the sides of the triangle. In this chapter, we will generalize the concept of trigonometric ratios to trigonometric functions and study their properties. Okay. Now, when we go through the point triangles, in previous classes you have studied about triangle. When we draw a triangle, if you consider a triangle, okay, so it consists of vertices, which are denoted by points, sides or edges, okay, edges which are in between two points. If you consider edge A, it is in between two vertices, okay. So there are three sides for a triangle, and for triangle there are three angles, okay. So in this unit, first we studied about angles. What do we know about angles? Or in previous classes you also know about angles, what, how we define it. So we will go through this again. Now, angle is measure of rotation of a given ray about its initial point. The original ray is called the initial side, and the final position of the ray after rotation is called the terminal side of the angle, and the point of rotation is called the vertex. Okay. If the direction of rotation is anticlockwise, the angle is said to be positive, and if the direction of rotation is clockwise, then the angle is said to be negative. So if we consider this as an initial side, if we write it is a vertex, this as a initial side of an angle, and this is our terminal side. Terminal side, here it is vertex O, if you can consider it as A and B. Now here it is angle in clockwise direction. Okay, this is considered because this is our initial side, so this is considered in anti-clockwise direction, so it is of positive angle. Positive angle. Okay, if we consider and this as an initial side, and this as a terminal side, and angle in opposite direction, which is clockwise direction. This is our clockwise direction. Okay. Now this angle is known as negative angle. Okay. So in this, from above definition, you can say that this is our initial side, and after rotation of an angle, this will give us a terminal side. And in which direction it is rotated, which will give positive and negative angle. Now, the measure of an angle is amount of rotation performed to get the terminal side from the initial side. Okay, so if this is our initial side, and we have to rotate, if we rotate it through 360 degree, so initial side will only gives us our terminal side. Okay. So here it is a completion of one rotation. Okay. When initial line and initial side and terminal side coincide with each other. So here we complete our first rotation. Now when we are measuring the angles, the unit of an angle is defined as a degree. Okay, so now to define a degree measure, degree measure, we can say that if a rotation from the initial side, to terminal side is 1/360 of a revolution, the angle is said to have a measure of 1 degree. Which is written as 1:0. Okay, which is notation of 1 degree. Now, from definition degree measure, you can see that a rotation from initial side, this is our initial side, to the terminal side, when we are rotated through this, okay, when we get a terminal side, is 1/360. Total angle is, if we count, it is 360 degree. So 1/360 of revolution, the angle is said to be 1 degree. Okay, and the degree is divided into minute, so we can write here 1 degree is equal to 60 minute. Okay, a degree is divided into 1 degree is equal to 60 minute, and 1 minute can be say as 60 seconds. Okay, now we draw some angles. Now in that, first it is 360 degree. If we draw this as a initial side, we denote a vertex by O, this as a vertex A. So when we draw a terminal side, it will be coincide with initial side only, so our 360 degree will be look like this. Okay, second is our 180 degree. So here it is our initial side OA, and 180 degree when we count on a protractor, you can get it opposite to initial side, so this angle totally gives us as 180 degree. Okay, O here B. Okay, this is our initial side and this is our terminal side. Now to draw 270 degree, here if you consider this as an initial side, it is O A. Now 270 degree, so it will be perpendicular in negative, or its total angle will be 270 degree, which is our terminal side. Okay, now it is count in anti-clockwise direction. Okay, here it is count in anti-clockwise direction. If you count in clockwise direction, it will be 90 degree. Okay, and it will be negative, minus 270 degree, which means minus 90 degree also. Okay, now next 420 degree. Now to draw 420 degree, now this is our initial side OA, and 420, here it is counted, here it completes 360 degree. Okay, and it remains 420 minus 360, which is equal to 60 degree. Now here it will be somewhere here and it will be 60 degree, so this total will be count as 420 degree. Okay, this is our terminal side. Now for negative, if you draw minus 30 degree, this is our initial side OA. Now here angle is negative, minus 30 degree, which angle is negative, so we have to rotate in clockwise direction. So in clockwise direction, it will be somewhere here and it is -30 degree. Okay, consider it as B. Now similarly for 420 degree, -420 degree, if this is our initial side OA, now it will -420. For -420 it is in clockwise direction, so this is our 360 completed, and somewhere here it will be 420 degree again, so here it is count as -420 degree. Okay, now here we study about a degree in which angle is measured, and also angle is measured in radian measure. Okay, now in radian measure there is another unit of angle is called radian measure. Okay, and angle subtended at the center by an arc of length 1 unit, this is 1 unit in a unit circle, okay, this is our unit circle, is said to have a measure of 1 radian. So this measure is here 1 radian. Okay, and its circle with unit, it is a unit circle, that means its distance or its radius is 1 unit. Okay, so and this angle will be 1 radian, and here OA is our initial side and OB is our terminal side. Okay, so this is our plus positive 1 radian. For negative it will be in opposite direction, we draw in this only, so if we consider this, so it will be our -1 radian. Okay, so here angle subtended at the center by an arc of length 1 unit, that means this circle of 1 unit, and it is here initial side OA is of 1 unit, and the terminal side is also 1 unit, because this both are radius. Okay, now angle in this between AOB is 1 radian. Okay, because this is circumference of a circle, okay, which is you know that the circumference of a circle is a twice pi r. Okay, so for a twice pi r is a circumference of a circle. Now when radius is 1 unit, then circumference of circle will be twice pi. Okay, so here the complete revolution of initial side, so complete revolution will subtend an angle of twice pi radian here. Okay, and for 1 radian it is 1 here, from it angle should be 1 radian. Thus we know that circumference of a circle of radius 1 unit is twice pi, thus one complete revolution of the initial side subtend an angle of 2 pi radian. Okay, now more generally, in a circle of radius arc, an arc of length r will subtend an angle of 1 radian, it is well known that equal arc of a circle subtend equal angle at the center, subtend equal angle at the circle, sorry, at the center, since a circle of radius r, an arc of length r subtend an angle whose measure is 1 radian. Full stop. Or comma, an arc of length L will subtend an angle whose measure is L upon R radian. Okay, for in this example its arc length is 1, okay, and radius is also 1, so 1 upon 1 it will be 1 radian. Now if we in general if you consider it is as center with radius R, okay, this is center with radius R, and here arc length is L, this arc length is L, then this angle will be L upon R radian. Okay, or you can say that thus if in a circle of radius R an arc of length L subtend an angle theta radian at the center, we have theta is equal to L upon R, or L is equal to R theta. Okay, now consider the relation between radian and real numbers. Okay, consider the unit circle with center O. This is a unit circle with center O and its radius OA is 1 unit. Okay, consider OA as initial side of an angle. This is our initial side of an angle. Then the length of an arc of the circle will give the radian measure of the angle which the arc will be subtended at the center of the circle. First of all, consider the line PAQ. Here line PAQ, okay, which is tangent to the circle at O. Which is tangent? Tangent means it is perpendicular at A. Okay, and it touches only one point at the circle. Let the point A represent real number 0. This point A represent a 0 on this real line. If you consider it as a real line, AP represent positive real number. It's represent positive real number, and AQ represent negative real number. Okay, and if we rope the line AP in anticlockwise direction, AP in anticlockwise means this, in this direction. Okay, and AQ in clockwise direction, AQ in this direction, clockwise direction, then every real number will corresponding to a radian measure. Okay, real number, this real numbers will corresponding to radian measure, and conversely, which means opposite to this statement, real number will corresponding to radian measure and radian measure will corresponding to real number. Okay, thus radian measure and real numbers can be considered as one and the same. So that from this statement is important, radian measure and real numbers are same in angle. Okay, now relation between degree and radian. So here 2 pi radian is equal to 360 degree. 2 pi radian is equal to 360 degree, and pi radian is equal to 180 degree. So 1 radian is equal to 180 degree upon pi is equal to, it is approximately 57 degree 16 minute approximately, and 1 degree is equal to pi upon 180 degree, 180 radian. pi upon 180 radian, and it is approximately 0.01746 radian. Okay, so this is a relation between degree and radian. So here some degrees are converted into radian part. So 30 degree can be written as pi upon 6, 45 degree is written as pi upon 4, 60 degree pi upon 3, 90 degree as pi upon 2, 180 degree as pi, 270 degree as 3 pi upon 2, and 360 degree as 2 pi. As in degree, this total one rotation is 360 degree. Okay, and in radian it is twice pi, and it's radian. Okay, so this 2 pi radian is equal to 360, which is relation between degree and radian. Now to find one radian, it can be written as 360 degree upon twice pi, okay, which gives 180 degree upon pi, okay, which is approximately, if you calculate it, it will give 57 degree and 16 minute. It is approximately. So here we write this notation. Now to convert degree in radian, here we write one radian in degree. Okay, now 1 degree is equal to, can be written as here 2 pi upon 360 degree radian, or which can be written as pi upon 180 degree, which should be considered as reciprocal. Pi upon 180, it's not degree. Okay, so it is converted into radian. So 2 pi upon 360 radian, 1 degree is equal to, and pi upon 180 is 1 degree. Okay, and it is approximately equal to 0.01746. Okay, so here we can write, so when we have given degree measure, we will convert into radian measure by multiplying pi upon 180 to degree. Okay, and degree measure can be written as 180 upon pi into radian measure. Okay, so this radian measure can be converted into degree measure. For example, today we will stop here, and next lecture we will convert the examples radian measure into degree measure and degree measure into radian measure. Thank you.